Yo, what's up? It's Patrick from Guy in the Cube. We've been talking about workloads inside of Fabric. And one of the things we haven't touched on specifically is the endpoints that are available when you create a lakehouse in a warehouse. And we've been getting questions about it. What's the difference? What are they? What can you do with them? What can't you do with them? And Adam and I had a funny interaction when we were up in Norway at Fabric February, where we had this debate about whether or not you can use SQL. Notice I didn't say T-SQL to create objects and insert data into those objects using the lakehouse, using SQL. And Adam was adamant that you couldn't do it. And I was like, of course you can. And so I'm going to show you all these things in this video. So enough of all this talking, you know what I would like to do? Let's head over to my laptop. So you can see in my workspace, I have a few items. Specifically, I have a lakehouse and a warehouse. When you create a lakehouse, you get the lakehouse, the default semantic model, and you also get a SQL Analytics endpoint. When you create the warehouse, you just get the warehouse and the semantic model. And you may be thinking, well, Patrick, you said you get an endpoint when you create both. You absolutely do. But there's some differences between them. So to get to the analytics endpoint in the lakehouse, you can click the lakehouse itself, and then you can switch over to the SQL Analytics endpoint, and that'll bring you to the view where you can start querying items and doing stuff like that. Or you can click directly on the SQL Analytics endpoint and it'll take you to the exact same view. If you want to get the endpoint itself, what you would do, regardless of which path you took to get here, you click the little settings gear and then you'll see the SQL connection string and you can copy this on your clipboard. And you can see this is telling you what this is for, right? You copy this string to use it to connect externally to an item from Power BI Desktop or client tools like SSMS, Azure Data Studio, anything that can connect to SQL Server. You can use this endpoint to it. And then you can also get to the endpoint by simply clicking on the ellipsis for the analytics endpoint and copy the connection string. For the warehouse, you would click the warehouse and you click settings, and then you can copy the endpoint there. Or just like the analytics endpoint for the lakehouse, you can click it and you can copy the connection string. Once you have the connection string on the clipboard, you can go to tools like Power BI, Management Studio, or Azure Data Studio. You can create a new connection and then you pop that server name in with the database name, switch the authentication to universal with MFA, and you can get authenticated. And now you can see here, I have my objects in my warehouse. That's my endpoint. That's the name of the database. And then in my lakehouse, that's the endpoint. And that's the name of the lakehouse. Both endpoints allow you to connect to the warehouse or the lakehouse. You can write queries and you can view the objects in the corresponding items, okay? Now, there's three types of queries that you would typically run. You would run data definition, you would use data manipulation language and data query language. And there's differences between the two depending on the endpoint you use. From a data definition perspective, the warehouse gives you full capabilities, right? You can create tables, procedures, views, functions. With the analytics endpoint that you get with the lakehouse, you have a limited set of things you can do. So you can create views and functions and even store procedures, but you cannot create tables. So if I head back over to the warehouse, I have a query that I've created. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to run this. So this will drop the table if it exists and it'll go ahead and create the table. So I'm going to run this and it creates the object. So I'm going to copy this on my clipboard and let's go ahead and refresh this just so you can see that that table was created. Boom, you can see my table was created. Let's hop over to the lakehouse. Let's open the lakehouse, the analytics endpoint for the lakehouse, so we can write a query. And we're going to drop this right here and let's run this. Let's see what happens. Let's try to run this. It says you can't create tables. So using T-SQL, remember I said T-SQL, you cannot create tables with the analytics endpoint, but with the endpoint in the warehouse, you can create those tables. So data definition is limited. And I'll circle back to this when I get to data query language to show you what you can do with the lakehouse in regards to creating objects. Okay. Now, from a data manipulation perspective, with the warehouse, you can absolutely write insert statements, update statements, and delete statements. With the analytics endpoint in the lakehouse, it's read-only. You cannot manipulate data. So if I go back over to my warehouse and I'm gonna insert some data. So let's go ahead and insert that data. There you go. My data is inserted. We'll run a query and I'll show you. But I'm not even gonna try it in the lakehouse because you just can't. You can't create tables and you can't manipulate data, okay? What about data query? If I just wanna read the data out, well, let me show you. I'm back in my warehouse and if I do a select, I'm gonna do a quick select right here and you'll see, boom, I can query that data. If I head over to the lakehouse, I'm gonna head over to the analytic endpoint for the lakehouse. And so we have a query here. Let's see if we can run this. I'm in my lakehouse. Well, it says no, it doesn't because no tables exist, but I can do three-part naming. I can say my warehouse, if I can spell. It even gave me IntelliSense and I ignored it. And so we'll run this query and I can do a three-part name from the lakehouse to the warehouse. So if the lakehouse and the warehouse are in the same workspace, I can say my warehouse dot schema dot object name, and I can select from the table in the lakehouse. All right, we can query away in both. We can even use three-part naming. Now, when I started this conversation, I said data definition is limited in the lakehouse because you can't create tables, but you can create objects. Let me show you. So I'm over here in my lakehouse view and I can say drop proc if exists, get products, go. And then I can say create proc, get products, as. I can add parameters. I can do all types of things here. So I'm going to run this. It'll drop that procedure and it'll create it. And then I can run that procedure directly and it returns my data. I can add parameters. I can do all types of things. If I go to schemas, you can see I can create views. I can create functions. I can create stored procedures. While you don't have the full parity of the T-SQL DDL language inside of the lakehouse, you still can create objects. You can't manipulate the data and you can't create tables, but you still have that ability. Now, Adam and I had this debate in front of a room of like 90 people. He said, you said, Patrick, you can't create tables using T-SQL. I said, T-SQL. From a Spark SQL perspective, you can absolutely do it. And that's my little loophole, because Adam was like, oh, you can't do it. I was like, challenge accepted, my friend. Let me show you. I created this little notebook and let's go to edit. Let's clear all my outputs so we can start from scratch. And so I'm gonna run this. I'm gonna run this. In just a few seconds, it's gonna create that object. It's gonna create this table for me. So if I click a refresh right here, you're gonna see there's my table, right? And if I wanted to insert data, I could run this. And what you'll see is that it'll insert some data into that table. And if I run a quick select, you're gonna see, boom, there's my data. Adam was like, wait, Patrick. I'm like, yes, just by changing the language of that code cell. So if I go in the code cell, you can see at the top, I put a little percent SQL, or I can switch it using the picker right here to Spark SQL. Using Spark SQL, which is a SQL language, I can actually create tables and manipulate data in my lakehouse. He was like, okay, man, I quit. I give up. You're right. I'm like, of course I am, right? I'm always right. Anyway, all right, what do you think? Have you been working with these analytics endpoint? There are definitely some things you should look at. I'm including a doc in the comments below that talks about how the lakehouse and the warehouse can work better together. And there's some section in there about how you can use these endpoints to do three-part naming and query across. You should check it out. If you have any questions, comments, you know what to do. Post it in the comments below. If you want to learn more about Fabric, all the Fabric workloads, I guarantee there's a video flying above my head. And as always, from Adam and myself, thanks for watching. We'll see you in the next video. I'm out.